I was born in Lahore to a family with both urban and rural cultural value systems. And at the very beginning of my life, my father taught me how to become a very active political participant in the society. And my mother, at that stage, induced in me the love for the city, the culture, the arts, and the food of Punjab. My love for the city grew deeper and deeper when I joined NC as a student, where we were exposed to the performative theater and the cultural art scene of Lahore, and we were supposed to go on streets and roam around the city and see what the city has to offer. So I grew up with this belief in during those times that Lahore is a city which proves that proverb, Dine Lahore di vekhe aur jamiai nahi, and nahi risan shahar Lahore diyan. So I believed Lahore is a city where people have struggled and they have always sustained their livelihood amidst whatever bad times comes, surpassed all those times, because they are basically laid back and basically their love for food is very important to them. But I was proved wrong. On 14th February 2006, a mob took over Lahore, the Mall Road, and it ransacked the whole Mall Road because they were protesting the blasphemous cartoons publication by Danish publishers newspaper. And in doing their protest, they demolished the mindset and belief system which I had as a very innocent person. And what they did was they set buildings on fire, they broke into the windows, they broke into the banks, looted the ATMs, and doing all that kind of atrocities to the city, I was wondering what is happening to the Lahore, what is wrong with these people, and Lahoriyon ka kasoor kya tha. So I was wondering all of these things when I thought I need to respond. And I was documenting that protest. And in my documentation, I collected more than 500 images. And this work, Nehri San Sher Lahore Diyan, is one such work where I show an innocent girl who is playing in front of a damaged facade of a building on Mall Road, and she's skipping rope in front of it and representing what I went through, and in terms of how the dreams of people in this city have been shattered. In terms of, you know, sharing all these contrasting and challenging complexities, my biggest challenge as an artist was to really come up with a process which documents best how I want to express my feelings. And in doing that, I really rely a lot on layers, lot of layers, because the life is not very simple in black and white. And lenticular medium is one such technique which I use a lot in my artwork, which creates these layers and help me transform these images and place them next to each other, where they play with each other, with the movement of the viewer whenever the viewer is seeing. So I use a lot of irony, complexities, and some kind of playfulness to talk about the atrocity. Then I wrote my love letter to Lahore, and in that visual love letter, I used one of the images of the building which was shattered. And the lips image, which you see on the bottom right, is the one which I wanted to show, which you placed on the love letter at the bottom to show your love. But it was at the spot where a stone has broken into the window and the shattered glass, its sharp blades are piercing through the lips, the delicate flesh of the lips. So the love letter to Lahore was bleeding. And I really wanted to correct all these things which I was seeing, because it was affecting my memory of a very beautiful city, a romanticized image of the city with beautiful cultural and visual landscape. So I wanted to correct things. And in order to correct things, one of the most atrocious image which I saw on that day in front of Charing Cross was of a car which was turned over after setting it on fire. And in order to correct what was happened, I flipped the image, I turned it upside down. But in trying to correct the situation, what happened was the tree behind the car was also turned over. So darakht ulta ho gaya usme. So in order to correct the things, cheezein ulti hoti gayi. So I felt really hopeless that you cannot correct whatever has been done wrong in this city. And my understanding of the city went another transformation in 2009 when I was doing my research, PhD research in London, so I had to come back. And I saw lots of raised walls in the city. The city landscape was changing. And there was a lot of barbed wire. So us sheher ki unchi diwar is one such response to the changing landscape of Lahore. And I longed to create a moment where I could connect with the nostalgic memory of the Lahore, with all its life. So diwar ke saaye mein ugti ghaas, diwar ke saaye mein motiye ka pauda are such images which talks about some ray of hope and light. The continuous sight of barbed wire in Lahore was something which was very disturbing for me. And I wanted to really see and hold back to that memory of people when they must be sharing beautiful sentiments with each other, the human touch. So I decided to see in the violent images of barbed wire the love. And if you look at the rolling, intertwining chains of barbed wire, I could see hearts. So Us Shahar Mein Mohabbat was the title of this work. And I was also wondering, there must be some crossroad in Lahore where someone is selling gajras. Or koi to gajre khareed ke kisi ko de raha hoga mohabbat se to his or her beloved. And that hope for love was reinforced in me because I visited at that moment Andhroon Shahar. And Wall City, the Andhroon Shahar, was such a place where it was so different to see there was no scare, there was no fear, which was engulfing the whole city earlier. Around Wall Street, there was a lot of barbed wire, but in the Wall Street, there was no such thing. The very essence of Wall Street's town planning provides its people to live in close proximity. And that is the reason why they are able to live their human values. They can connect with each other. And so I decided to create this work, Ek Shahar Jo Udaas Hai. And I documented the life on street and placed those lives and the images on the rooftop of the architecture, the residence of people in Wall Street, and created this fantasized city where the life continues to go on free of scare and fear on the rooftop because the roads are not safe. That gave me enough spirit to think in reflection about my city. And I decided that I want to reclaim it. In reclaiming the city, I decided to go on a walk to retrace my footpath, my area, my route, which I used to take place normally. So I asked my friend to document me while I'm walking in the city. And during that documentation, a story has to be documented. A story has to be written. So I become the narrator. I become the protagonist. Or maybe a flaneur through my walk, this 70 feet long walk. I tell you a story about a city with lots of complexities, layers, juxtaposed on each other. So when I went to the walk, I show glances, gaze, male gaze, my interaction with people, very few, maybe smaller in number. hawkers, legal infrastructure, guards, etc., etc. But this segment of the walk which I'm showing here is the most complex one. Because what is happening, when I was walking, I saw a flag painted on the wall which was representing a militant band organization's flag, inviting people to join them. And in doing that, I was wondering that, look at the dare and the courage of these people. They are so open and obvious. And someone was making tea in front of it, a hawker, and for his livelihood. And the smoke created of that, because of that tea making, tarnished the whole flag black. And another person who came by pasted some advertisements of a local clinic claiming to cure male sexual issues. So for me, the complexity in one spot in the city was so interesting, that a male sexuality, power, brutal power are juxtaposed together. So how to relate and how to interpret it? And then jinne Lahore nahi vekhya o jamya hi nahi, that's where I see my existence, my livelihood, that I continue to live. And because I continue to live, I need to continue to interpret, document, and make meaning of what is this city has to offer in terms of its visual, textual, and material culture. Thank you.